What's up, guys? As you know, on this YouTube channel, I'm going to go through each individual game, multiple games. I'm going to educate you guys, show you guys how to be sharks. This is day two. I'm going to do 100 straight days. We're going to absolutely stack this right here. Strictly is just my game lines, game spreads. My next video will be DFS lineups, but let's get straight into it. These are 5 to 10 minute videos where I just run through and show you guys a little something. All right, so let's look at it. Let's look at the free play I gave today. So the free play, let's see, the computer's taking a little longer. Let's see. So here's the free play I gave. I gave it out on my Instagram, SharkDogBro. It was in college basketball, and you know, I really jumped all over this. Let me get down to it for you guys. We have USC versus Arizona State. The line, as you see right here, opened as a pick'em, which means like they don't have a lean, anything like that. Okay. Now you see the line is -3.5. I got in at -3, but as you see right here, the line is -3.5. So let's click it. Let's see why. There's a lot of reasons why. I'll tell you guys right now. But we'll get straight into it. So let's look at the view line movement. So you always want to look at the line movement because sharks bet early. So come up here, go to spread. Okay. Look at that. -1, -2. -1.5, -2, -3, -2.5, -2.5, -2.5, -3.5. And the reason for this, sharks did jump on it early. So they did jump on Arizona State early. And like I told you guys before, when you're dealing with basketball, you want to keep under 5 because that is when teams at the end of the game stop fouling and won't get above that number. So let me explain. So say a team is up 3. The other team's going to keep fouling because they feel like they're still in the game. Once it gets to 5, there'll be 20 seconds left to let the clock go, okay? Let's look at it. Let's look at the money spread percentage. So as you see right here, 53% of the money is on Arizona State with 81% of the money on that 3.5. Which means this line more than likely will probably move to 4, but I got it at 3, so already we got a positive EV, positive expected value. Okay, so let's go money line. Look at that, money line. Now, this is different from NFL and games like that where you fade the public, simply because there's so many college basketball games. They're not really focused on one game like today. They're going to be focused on NFL, where there will be a majority of the bets, and there's only 2 NFL games, so that's where you really want to look to fade the public and things like that. But here, on these games like this with small volume, so if you go, we'll go back real quick. I'll show you guys what I mean by this real quick. So do you see right here where's that? See how it says 3.4 thousand bets? That's all there is, 3.4. This is so low. Look at this, 11.4. And I guarantee if you go to NFL, look at the difference. So you guys can know. Look, 278,000, 323,000. Massive difference. So put it like this. If you're the sports book, you are going to want to focus in on the games that have all the money on it. You're not going to focus on a game that has 3,000 bets, okay? So you're not going to want to do that. So let's go back and look at the game. A bunch of injuries for USC. A bunch of people questionable. They did just play. So I think a lot of these players will be sitting, and that's why I think the line is where the line is at. But either way, I still like Arizona State. But I believe you have Ellis sitting. See, look, you have Ellis sitting. I know you have Rodman sitting. And there was somebody else sitting. And you can just see, look at the rebounding advantage. So you come here, look at their rebounders, 4.1. We'll just say everybody's playing. 4.1, 2.6, 4.7, 4.5. They have nobody over 5 rebounds a game. You come over to Arizona State. Yes, you got 5.5. You got 5.1. You got 4.2. So you got some guys that can rebound. You got guys that are scoring over double digits. USC can have a couple of these, 2 of these guys out. Okay? So automatically right there. Then I want to come here and look at defense. Then I want to look at the and it's hard. When you're dealing with college basketball, you really can't use these rankings because a lot of teams play harder schedules. Like if you go to Arizona State, so let's do this. So if you go Arizona State basketball previous games, okay, lost to UCLA, but they had that game in the bag. Literally, I mean, look at they were up, they blew it in the second half. But let's look. This is why you can't use rankings because they don't really do them based off of who you played. So look, they went in. They got destroyed by Washington, went in and beat a very good Colorado team, went in and beat a very good Utah team, beat a California team that's very good, beat a Stanford team. We got destroyed by Northwestern. Northwestern is tough. Got destroyed by TCU. These are all teams that are, you know, tournament time teams that could make Elite Eight, Sweet 16 runs. San Fran's very good team. SMU, beat on them. Okay, so then UMass Lowell, very, very good team. Texas, Arizona State, beat on them. Now let's go back and look at USC. USC basketball predictions. Okay? Not predictions. USC basketball previous games. Okay, so you go here. got destroyed by Arizona. That game wasn't even close. Got destroyed by Colorado, a team that Arizona State beat. Got destroyed by Washington State. They just don't have consistency. So in this game, really, like I'm looking at Arizona State here in this game. I like them this game. I like the -3. It's currently -3.5. I still like -3.5 because it's under 3. Okay, let's go to another game just to teach you guys, educate you guys, show you guys what I'm seeing. Let's see a game that had sharp money. We'll find a game that had big things on it. Okay, so for instance, let's see, what do I want to find for you guys? We'll look at a game like this. I'm not gonna look at that. Alright, look at Cornell. So you look at a Cornell team, we'll go to Cornell and Brown. So when you look at Cornell and Brown, you see a 12-3 team against a 5-12 team. You look at the spread, you think it should be a little higher. I think Cornell is very, very tough. Look at this. The line was just -6. It moved back down, but look, 40% with 98% of money. 5.5. Let's see if the line moved. Let's see if there's sharp movement. So you always go to the favorite team, which just makes it easier. So we'll go to Cornell. It opened up at 3.5, jumped to 4.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5, 5, 5, and it got down to 6. So let's go look. Let's go look what we see in Cornell. Cornell, very tough team. Very, very tough. They actually have a better away record than Brown has home. But this is where I really like Cornell. So here's what I do. So you go to Cornell basketball player stats. This is where I really like it. Okay. Go to Cornell. Go to player stats. Look at this. They have 4 guys averaging double figures in points. Rebounds, not really too many rebounds. Okay. Then you go to Brown. Brown basketball player stats. You want to come here. And you see, they got 3 guys that can do it. They got rebounding. They got all that. But here's why I love Cornell. Okay? You can't just look at the numbers. So you go Brown, previous games. Let me show you guys. You go Brown, previous. Brown University. Previous games. Brown University basketball. Fight with me today. There we go. Brown University basketball previous games. Look at this. Got beat by Yale, got beat by Vermont, got beat by Stony Brook, barely beat a horrible Siena team, got destroyed by Providence, that's expected. Rhode Island, got destroyed by Maine, they're just not putting up points. Got destroyed by Ohio, got lost to Ohio, lost to USC, those are games they expected. But look at this Cornell team. This Cornell team right here is tough. This Cornell team is tough. I'm showing you guys these because I watched the game, so I realized, but if you don't watch the game, you can look at these. Like, they beat a really good Colgate team. They went in there, lost to Baylor and Baylor, beat a very good Penn team, beat a very good Robert Morris team, destroyed Siena, went in, had a good fought battle against Syracuse. Lafayette's good, Monmouth's good. George Mason only lost by 7 at home, beat Fordham. I think they're battle-tested. I like Cornell today in this game. Let's do one more game for you guys. And I got one more good one for you guys, because this game's going to blow your mind, okay? So when you're looking at these games, you also, especially later in the season, you want to see... You want to see who has played before. So, for instance, where's Georgia State? Let's look for Georgia State. This is a game that I was looking at. Georgia State. Let's see. Yale, Drexel. Georgia State. Let's see. They're playing Georgia State. Okay, so look. You got a 9-8 team against a 3-15 team. Line opened up at only -2.5, okay? Now here's where you have to ask yourself, why the heck is that line so small? You got a team that has a winning record against a team that has a losing record. You know, usually those are trap games. But here's where it gets me. Ready? Look right here. Previous games. Georgia State just beat this team 90-62. Now, you can ask yourself, you can say, oh, maybe they just had a bad game. Maybe this team, like, you don't just beat a team by 28 points. You don't. Georgia State was doing whatever they wanted. And here's the thing. You can't say, oh, maybe Georgia Southern was just cold and Georgia State was hot. Georgia State only made 9 threes. 2 more threes than Georgia Southern. Which means Georgia State is getting high quality shots down low. I love it. I like it. The line was -7.5 last game. They're getting high quality shots. And you know, if you can't, you can stop, like, a team can shoot the 3 and be cold. But can you really stop a team that drives? Can you really, like, stop a team that is scoring down low at that rate? And plus, Georgia State's playing very good. Beat Old Dominion, beat USA. Georgia Southern beat Coastal Carolina, but I mean, I don't see too much here. I'm playing this based strictly off of the previous game, when you beat a team by 28, I don't think you come back in here and win a game. I don't care if you're at home or not. Okay? Guys, we're going to continue to do these. I'm going to do 100 straight days. I hope you guys were able to learn something. Continue to learn as we continue to go. I'm going to continue to give plays. So you're getting plays in between this. You're seeing what I'm seeing. Let's make some money.